Hello, world of YouTube, and welcome to another episode of Redacted, the show where I take a look at records that have a solid foundation, but a spotty execution, and making a smoother listening experience out of it. This week's just all funky, what can I say? But this month, we're going to be tackling another pop-fueled record in the vein of what I did with Everything Everything, but instead of looking at another art-pop band, we're actually going to go a little more into radio-friendly pop music. We're going to be taking a look at an artist who has had really big singles, but also has this adoring fan base within the internet. And I'm a fan of her work. I think that she's an incredible singer. She really taps into that vintage vibe incredibly well. And she made one of my favorite songs of the 2010s. And the record in question is the follow-up to the record that had that song. Not to say that it was a bad record by any stretch of the imagination, but following that record's release, she released a batch of B-sides that had just as many songs as the A-side. So I'm going to try and tie them together. Talking about the fourth record by Canadian pop singer Carly Rae Jepsen, Dedicated. Party for one. Back on my feet. You don't want my love if you don't care about me. Now, I had no problems with Dedicated when it dropped. In fact, I thought it was a really solid follow-up to Emotion that was a little bit tighter, had some good bops still, and saw her still kind of exploring that vintage pop flair that she had explored heavily on Emotion. And, you know, I thought at the end of the day, it was a solid 7 out of 10. Couldn't go wrong with that. But then, last year, she decided to drop a B-sides collection, which was what she did with Emotion, but it was another full-length dose of B-sides featuring even more sonic, you know, experimentations into other realms and collaborations with other artists and stuff. And when listening to Dedicated Side B, I couldn't help but think, man, some of these tracks really could have made Side A an even better listening experience and further cementing some of the lyrical themes seen on Dedicated and plant some more thematics. And so what I'm here to do today is meld those two projects together into a smooth, bright pop record that has loads of bops, great anthemic choruses, and generally trim some of the more meddling pieces of Side A and Side B into one project, while also retaining, again, some of those lyrical themes of love, lost, fawning, all the sort. Now, on top of that, there was also a single, a notorious single that came out before Dedicated, that still feels like it fits the Dedicated era of Carly Rae Jepsen's career. You already know what it is. It came out a couple years or a year before Dedicated, and so I put that on here as well. But my version of Dedicated is 12 tracks and 40 minutes long, so let's go ahead and break it down. Now, don't get me wrong, I like Julian. I think it's a really strong song, and I think it has a tight groove, and it has, again, that sort of love-leaning lyrics that a lot of Dedicated aims for really strongly. But while it is the closer to the original Dedicated, I put Party for One here because I'm sort of using it in a filmmaker's terms. I'm using it as a start at the end before flashing back to the beginning sort of scenario, while also leading with easily the best execution of, like, just a tight, big, anthemic pop jam that Carly made throughout both of these projects. There's a lot of good pop songs on both of these projects, but I think Party for One is the biggest hit, the best hitting song on both projects. You know, it's got an incredible build-up, a great chorus, and even an incredible, really catchy bridge, you know, and again, while thematically starting at the end, we do eventually get back to the beginning right away with the track Happy Not Knowing, which immediately delves into some of the frustrations that the protagonist may be having with her current lover. And that continues to sort of go with the tight groove of Happy Not Knowing that sort of picks up from where Party for One sort of bleeds off with another good bright chorus talking about the frustrations before transitioning into an even more low-key cut that really nails down a sort of planting and payoff moment on this project. There's two tracks on the side B that have the way, way, way looping verses, songwriting style, and Felt This Way was the first on side B, and it's the first on this, because I think it's a good moment in side B that I wanted to still have here that still sort of cements the themes that the record was going for anyway, and I think it's a good, again, lower key bop. You know, it's not quite as big as the last two songs, but it's still catchy in its own regard, before really doubling into the love for a decent stretch of the record to sort of delve into the more love-struck era of the relationship or what the protagonist is going through, with Julian finally coming into play. Again, tight groove, really good chorus, you know, not a bad song in its own regard at all. I just didn't think it was a good opener. And I carry the groove of Julian into Want You in My Room, another vintage-sounding pop tune, sounds very summer of 91, but it carries the groove of Julian incredibly well and sees the protagonist sort of further delving into the realms of love in this relationship. Really solid jam. Love how intimate Carly Rae sounds on it, and I love the vocoded vocals. Incredible stuff. And from Want You in My Room, I wanted to delve even further into being more emotionally in it with Cut to the Feeling, a track that has Carly Rae really singing about that love in a heartfelt way. And it's a track that she recorded before Dedicated, but I felt like had to be here because it fits the era so incredibly well. I loved Cut to the Feeling when it came out. I think it's a bop, and it acts as sort of the centerpiece bop in the project, where Party for One, she's starting off single, flashing back to when she's at peak love, before going further down into the frustrations with more lower key bops in the form of Summer Love and Comeback, two tracks that have two different vibes, but they're again a lot more subdued than Cut to the Feeling was. But I love the groove of Summer Love, and I love how, again, she sort of writes about the frustrations that are being sort of coming to the surface with this relationship before really doubling down on that with Comeback. I love Comeback, and I think it's a really good atmospheric tinged cut. I think her work with Bleachers on here is so good. And again, the writing on it, it just feels really emotionally strong and sort of, again, continues to propel the themes incredibly well. There's no huge bright chorus on here, but the drops that do happen still have this sort of feeling of a weight to them that I think works incredibly well. Before spicing it up a little bit, you know, Comeback fades away, and we need some sonics to kind of bright up the groove again from that. Similarly to Summer Love with Feels Right, another really good just vintage bop with a really good piano loop and some fun little percussion sounds in there, and a much bigger chorus than on Comeback. It's sort of a nice little ramp up and vibe from that. That sort of, again, acts as a good turning point emotionally. Carly Rae still feels attached in this relationship, and that shows on this track in a nice way. Before shifting back into the payoff from Felt This Way with Stay Away, a track that has, again, similar lyrics, but in the context of where they're at following what's happened in the record, it feels like it has a little bit of a different flavor. And the vibe of the track is a little bit different, too. It has a little more of a modern feel. Again, the other thing I've been trying to do with this project is melding that vintage love that Carly Rae has with some of the modern stuff she was experimenting with on Dedicated in a fun way. And I like, again, the planting and payoff moment here that then leads really well into This Love Isn't Crazy, the sort of last point in the relationship where Carly Rae feels still super invested, but things clearly might not be all that healthy as things have been sort of alluding to, sort of frustrations burgeon within love. Still love at its core here. It's a great sort of resolve to that whole arc that the record's been sort of going towards. It's another bright bop that has, again, a good build-up. It was the opening to side B, and I use it as the penultimate track here before doubling down, bookending the project
with another love for Solo Life, the single life, Solo. A track that is another really big bop. It's just not as big as Love Isn't Crazy or A Party for One. But it's another good, huge, bright chorus exploring, again, the love of single life. And I think it's a good bookend to the emotional parts that this record has going on. And that's why I had it there. It was the penultimate track on side B, but I kept it as the final track to just sort of have that, again, sort of emotional resolve and kind of revolving back to square one. And that was my redaction on Dedicated. Like I said, sort of throughout the dissection of the track listing, my biggest focus was to have this sort of sonic ebb and flow to kind of mirror the ebb and flow of the relationship going on, a lot of the emotional lows and stuff. And I sort of used the three big bops as sort of accented points in the emotional state of the protagonist. You know, single life, deep in love, single life, all that sort of stuff. And while there were still great tracks from side A and side B that I didn't crop up on here, a lot of the tracks that I scrapped either leaned too heavily into the atmospheric vibe that side B had a lot going for it, and I wanted to keep that sort of a minimal to have a little more of an engaging experience. Or they sort of doubled down on the lyrical threads from the relationship-driven stuff in a way that I didn't think was as compelling as the tracks that I kept here. While there were tracks that I scrapped from side A, like Everything He Needs, that I feel like go a little too hard on those thematics of being too much and caught up in your head in the attachment of love, and I felt like almost detracted from the listening experience. One track that I did scrap that I almost, so almost, kept on this, it was like one of the last songs I decided to omit, was the song, the single Too Much, another single from this era that I felt like, while being very on the nose with its writing, sort of complemented a lot of the writing that was going on in the era of being caught up in your head in love, being swept up in it, maybe being too much for your lover. Something that Carly Rae has in the lyrics of some of the songs that I did keep, but I felt like the planting and payoff of Felt This Way, Stay Away had the same sort of thread, but in a much better, more dynamic impact, if that makes any sense. But I could see somebody wanting it on here. I almost had it be a lead into Solo, but ultimately scrapped it off the project. But I feel like this version of the record has a lot of the lyrical themes heavily cemented while having a much more sonically dynamic experience. And that was ultimately my goal. But what did you think of my redacted? Did you like it? Are there songs that I scrapped off of it that you enjoyed from the Dedicated era? Let me know in those comments down below. But if you did like this redacted, be sure to give it a like. If you want to see more of my music, gaming, and general nerdery content, be sure to subscribe. Special thanks to my patrons. If you want to join the ranks to get early access to content, exclusive content, or to help drive the community, it's linked in the description. I'm going to get out of here, though. Thank you so very much for watching. I've been Viral Rack. You guys have good days, lives, and situations. And I'll see you another day. Thank you.